So, Kerbal Space Program again. So what I had done previously, the last time I got to play this, I finally got my space station docked up with one of these little eco-dual things, which is funny because, so there's the station, St. Kitts Orbital, and this is the ship, ECO-Dual 10. Apparently, this one, I guess they name it after which one number is bigger, but yeah, so the ship is bigger because of the fuel pieces, but I will change that shortly, because probably what I'm going to do is, the intention was that these ECO duals would just run off the ion engines, right? So, not this next segment, I'm going to be doing another block, so this is the initial part of the space station, right? I'm going to do a second block here, and I've got, and then probably a third and a fourth, so that's the large docking port senior. What I have up here is the command module, so this is sort of commanding the station. It's basically a ship, except for it has no real rockets. It has RCS, and that's it. And I've got six of the junior docking ports wrapped around here, so I can dock six ships, although six might be a little painful. Turn on my lights. Oops, that's not my lights. Light. There we go. Solar panels on accident. So that's what I think I'm going to do now is I'm going to make block B, which will hook into this. And what I want block B to be, block B to be, or not to be, is gonna plug in here with this docking port senior. And the main thing I've been noticing, I waste a lot of RCS when I'm doing things. So I want... actually, how much RCS do I have? That's the monoprop, right? I'm gonna basically just run a segment up that's probably another six junior docking ports, maybe mediums, and then nothing but RCS fuel. So let's go to the Space Center. Let's go to the VAB. So I need a, I guess I could use an RGU, remote guidance. Nah, I want a Kerbal to actually be able to fly it. I kind of like the idea of it being actually an independent thing. Let's go size. Capola would be cool. Look at that. I like that. Yeah, I'll stick a Capola module. I think I can command from here. Also, I think there's an inline. guess this has to be. Oh, there's inline. Rotate it this way. There we go. So you go there. And then it's going to be on the side, right? And basically you'll have a stack. Oh, and then I actually do want to rotate this that way. Yep. And that'll be basically the middle of the ship. And then let me do some sort of passenger thing that it's sitting on. Where was the payload? Did that count as cargo? No. Where's passenger? I need that weird quad adapter thing. Quad. No. There's like a quad adapter. Connector. There we go. This thing. Actually, I don't like that at all. That is ugly because it's so small compared to the other bit. Let's just start there, and then let's do here. I guess I could do that. Not exactly the best. Heat shield. Oh, and I needed. Well, let's try this. Decoupler. Just to keep the thing a little bit heavier. Put a big giant heat shield on it. But this will probably do. Okay, that's not my ideal choice, but that's what I'm going with. And now, I basically just want RCS fuel. Mono prop. Take one. Two. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. That's a lot of mono prep. Can I color these? Yeah. I kind of like the Illinois. I'll go with that. But how many do I want? 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that 5? I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, let's do 5. And then I need a passenger unit. Yeah. And then I'll do a monoprop. Thank you. So I could put more juniors on it. I've thought about that. Or I could put some normals on it. Let's see what. What's four? Six. Is there any good way to put six on this thing? RCS. And then this can be a black horns. So that's an option now. Centered with the window. Yep. I'm gonna make this the five horn. There we go. There we go. So this is basically an independently flyable doodad. But basically just fuel. It all the way up and start figuring out what I want to do next. This is basically payload. That's what it boils down to. Oh, some lights around the docking. Those should probably be six. Yeah. Also six. Like that. Action groups. Custom one will be toggling the solar panels, because that's what I do with everything else. Okay. Crew. Let's do Minrad curb. Let's Oh, I can be put people in. Oh yeah, of course. But we already have an engineer up there. This is just a guy to fly the thing. Okay. And then the last thing I really want is what? I guess need a docking port senior on the bottom. Oh, am I doing this the wrong way? I am doing that the wrong way. There we go, now you can dock that way. I better double check that I did that one the right way. That way I can do block C. So this is just going to be a giant tower. Cool. Now I need to get this stupid thing up. So I'll do a stack separator. Oh, that's even bigger. That's even bigger. 25? Yep, there we go. 25. The difference between was a stack separator versus decoupler. Oh well. Oh, I think this separates both ways, and this separates just one way. So let's actually do that. Just right. So that's probably going to be the actually, I don't like that at all. What other options do I have? Orange. What I had originally. Okay. Yep, I'll go that way. Although, if this segment's making it up, maybe I shouldn't actually separate this here at all. Yeah, this will just. So, this. I'm gonna make this the whole thing. The intention being to keep this as part of the ship or the station. So this will be liquid fuel storage to get it up there. So this will be the orbiting stage. But even if they're like half empty, let's just keep them. I'll need to ditch. So I can ditch the Mastodon at some point and just have a tank. But honestly, I don't need to do that until I'm ready for Block C. I can just leave that on there for quite a while. And then I've got an option on the station. I kind of like this. And oh, you know what? I guess this doesn't get fuel. Yeah, this doesn't get fuel. Okay, so I need to run a fuel line. I'll need a strut. Just a tiny little gutter girder. Actually, maybe I'll do this gutter girder. That looks fun. Is there a beam? This is small, but all I need is a little beam. I can run the fuel. I'm confused. Let me confirm. If I put the engine here, then I have. Oh, yeah. I have a ton. Although, honestly, I need more thrust. Okay. Maybe this isn't an idea at all. So, scratch that. This will just be monoprop. Port senior, and then I need to rotate it this way. Bunk. And then stack separator, and then some liquid fuel. Maybe just this much. What's my delta V like now? Or my thrust weight ratio is 1.31. 6 seconds. Okay, so I think that'll be a reasonable final state. I'm gonna just give this a go. This will obviously not get into orbit. I just want to make sure that I have something reasonable built right now, and then I'll add the next bits of it. All right, so this is an experiment of. Look at that wobble. Oh yeah. Actually, I'm kind of surprised. It's doing as well as it's doing. Revert to vehicle assembly. Autostrad heaviest part. Yep. Cool. Aerodynamics. That's a more stable device. Oh yeah. Much more stable device. And then that's hilarious. It's still pushing it. Even though it's apart. I like it. That's crazy. Oh, now we're separating. Cool. This is actually out of order. This is actually, this stage goes first. Yeah. Now let's add more fuel tanks. Huge fuel tanks. Giant liquid fuel. I guess I need a stack separator. The 225 stack separator. And you can be in the same set as that. So I turn on that engine. Separate whenever I go to this, which we'll need cluster adapter. Cool. Let's put some juice underneath that. Engines. The biggies. 4,000 meters a second is nothing. Wow, okay. I'm still not... oh, but I've got a lot of burn, so... Maybe what I really need to do is... Try that. What's that look like? 1.47. It's right at it. This might work. This might make it. Let's try and launch. If not, I might just slap on some SRBs on the side of this thing. Alright. So. Full. Look at that go. Okay, that's not gonna make it. That's... going to... But I think this is gonna end very shortly. Revert to vehicle assembly. I clearly need some sort of something. Strike. Let's try that. Start in the east. Not that fast though. Not that fast though. Oh, okay. This might be something that'll orbit and dock and do all the things I want it to do. Okay. Then I've got it reversed. Honestly, pretty simple shit. Okay, now I'll slowly start pushing it back. Just in the pitch. My apoapsis is almost orbital now. I'm gonna let it get to 100 and then I'm gonna kill my engines. What about there? Alright, and now lock onto prograde map. Let's quickly make a maneuver node and figure out what I need to do to circularize my orbit. There we go. That'll work. I might pull it in a bit, actually. Let's just do 100, 100. I don't know. That'll work. Free to use RCS. You've got a lot of it. You've got a ton of RCS. Actually, that's not as much as I was thinking it'd be. I was hoping there'd be more RCS than that, honestly. Maybe should rethink this. Start to burn right about that. That's my target. So, we got a nice circular orbit. What's my ascending node is 1.6 degrees. So I'm gonna add a maneuver where let's see. My ascending node is up, so I want to bring it down. Which does, not quite. There we go. Burn time 3 seconds. That's gonna be difficult. So what I'm gonna do is make my thrust limiter like, can I type in here? Something like that. That's more reasonable. 26 seconds. Let's go forward in time. Let's turn on Perseus to get. Okay. What's my ascending node like now? 0.0, perfect. That's actually close. And for your first approach. And that'll be a prograde. Let's go there. Leave this on until the very end, pretty much. Just so she has a way in. Actually, you know what? No, screw it. There we go. And perfect. I'm gonna flip it just to get those stones out. Cool. Adding myself a safety stage so I don't accidentally ruin my day. So I probably want to run prograde. Okay, actually no, what I want to do is I want to add the apoapsis, add a maneuver such that I push it out. So that means burn it this way. That's just about perfect. Yeah, that's about perfect. 59 second burn in 3 minutes. And that is a pro grade burn. I've got a ton of electric charge too, so I don't even need my solar panels. by the way, heat shield. Now this is something I doubt you can do with real engines, like throttle them down to 10%. Like I could see 50%, but 10%. So, at the second intersection, my relative speed will be 123, so I want to be retrograde whenever I finally get there, which, so let's warp to here. Kilometers away. Did it already miss? So I'm going to set the target velocity to 0, relative to the target, and then I'm going to aim for it, over and over again. Slow it down soon. Oh, intersect two. Oh, that's cool. I don't think I realized it showed me that. Actually getting a pretty good picture of like what's what now. That's cool. Like I can see ECO Duel 10, and there you go. I can actually see where I want to dock. That goes there. See how fast I can do this. So that's where I'm going. Too fast. So let's slow this down. Oh, so close. Which is looking promising. Don't even think I'm going too fast. I don't know what the actual max speed you really can safely ram into this before you have problems is, but let's see if I can do this 1.5. Thank you. long can I sit and burn out this? Oh, forever. Pretty much forever. I'll run out of RCS before I run out of liquid fuel. Rotate this station That's too fast. That's a little too fast. Getting impatient. Let's try 2 meters a second. So that's about 4 miles an hour. To rotate this guy. Almost time to bonk. Almost time to bonk. Let's see what happens. 2.8. Can I do 2.8? Or is that too much? This might be too fast. think I'm gonna make it. Almost there. Almost there. 37. Yeah, that's still lined up. Almost there. Almost there. 19. There. Come on. Hey. Let's just snap it. We have a station. A slightly bigger station. Alright. That's cool. Let's reorient this thing. I have a station. I can deploy my solar sails too. Go. Cool. On that note, I will call it a night. St. Kitts orbital is a little bit bigger.